Welcome to BookSpot. Thank you for visiting Mary's Library. I'm Jane Miller, and our book for review today is God's Secretaries, The Making of the King James Bible by Adam Nicholson. The book is about 54 scholars and clergymen, varied in temperament and background, who were assigned by the new King James of England to write a new version of the Bible. 16th century England had gone through a yo-yo reformation with various versions of the Holy Scripture, but James wanted a new English Bible that would embody not only the kingliness of God, but also a Bible that could be understood by all Englishmen, no matter how low. And so, when this new Bible would be read aloud, it could be understood the word and glory of God. And what better time to try this literary experiment than the age of Shakespeare? The English language was at its zenith. And when these 54 scholars began to meet to write this new version, they knew Greek and Latin. In fact, they spoke Greek and Latin daily. And most importantly, they were versed in the ancient scriptures, so that they labored 7 long years, and they would meet in committee and read aloud their findings, because this was to be a Bible that was not only for the mind, but for the ear. Now, when the King James Version rolled off the presses in 1611, Shakespeare was writing his last play, The Tempest. And by the mid-1600s, this Bible had effectively replaced all of its predecessors. The King James Version of the Bible became the book that crossed the Atlantic with the traders and the colonists and went to Africa and India. And it became the most widely read book ever written. And in America, the book became the emblem of continuity for our nation. U.S. presidents, from Washington to Obama, have used the King James Bible to put their hand on and swear their oath of allegiance. Obama used Lincoln's Bible. And the poetic language and the stately rhythms of this version of the Bible echo today in the Gettysburg Address, Moby Dick, and the sermons and speeches of Martin Luther King. What is it about the King James Bible that is so loved? It's my favorite. I just love that the verses from Luke's Christmas story, when the shepherds are sore afraid, S-O-R-E, a good old English four-letter, one-syllable word, meaning they hurt all over. And Mary, great with child, so lovely, so true is that. It is an archaic saying that was used in England at the time. Let us now close with the most familiar and the most used of the verses in this Bible, and is probably being used somewhere right now. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Amen. And so we close this book now, God's Secretaries, The Making of the King James Bible.